guess it started off when I was in my undergrad years. I tried to do something to differentiate myself from all the other kids applying for internship the year after. So I actually came up with an idea to scale up this mountain, Mount Roraima, in the southern tip of Venezuela. And to do this, we obviously needed money. So the entire experience before the actual expedition of raising money and pitching the idea, just going out to people and saying, you know, I had this crazy idea, it's going to be really fun, it's going to be something different to do. Would you put some resources, some money on the table for us to do it? In the end, we got funded by several institutions like the National Geographic, Royal Geographic Society, UK, and by the university itself. And we had a blast like doing it, you know, just looking for the guys to actually do this track with me. Again, it was a totally different pitch, right? To sell this idea to these guys, like, look, I've got the resources in. You just gotta join me and camp out with me, you know, 10 nights in the middle of this jungle. So it was really interesting, and that started my addiction. Like, I kept thinking, you know, if that was so fun to do and so different, and it was relatively easy to convince people to jump on board and support me, why can't I do it for something else? Yeah, you wouldn't believe it, you know, like, we really started off as a six-man team. And the guy who was most qualified on paper, right? So the guy who's been a Boy Scout, he's gotten several Duke of Edinburgh Awards, he's traveled half of the world. 2 weeks before the trip tells me, you know, I don't feel like going fast, you know, I just don't feel safe. And in a way I guess you would say he chickened out, right? And I couldn't believe it, like, the most qualified guy on my team has now decided to drop out. So we had 2 weeks to make up all of the core competencies that we would lose by not having him in the team. So we had to I had to send a couple of guys for first aid training, a couple of other guys in like survival training, how to make a fire and everything, you know, to prepare for any eventuality. Stuff that this guy would have covered, we now had a huge gap in the team. So 2 weeks before the trip was actually the busiest time. And I learned there, like, the importance of trying to identify, like, you know, core processes within a project and how to have a safety plan behind each of those.